Casey at the bat. The outlook wasn't brilliant for the Mudville Nine that day. The score stood 4-2 with but one inning more to play. And so when Cooney died at first and Burroughs did the same, a sickly silence fell upon the patrons of the game. A straggling few got up to go in deep despair. The rest clung to the hope that springs eternal in the human breast. And they thought if only Casey could but get a whack at that, we'd put up even money now with Casey at the bat. But Flynn proceeded Casey, as did also Jimmy Blake. And the former was a no-good, and the latter was a fake. So upon this stricken multitude grim melancholy sat, for there seemed but little chance of Casey getting to the bat. But Flynn let drive a single, to the wonderment of all, and Blake, the much despised, tore the cover off the ball. And when the dust had risen, and they saw what had occurred, there was Blake safe at second, and Flynn a-huggin' third. And then from 5,000 voices went up a lofty yell. It rattled in the valley, it rumbled in the dell, it rang upon the mountain top and recoiled upon the flat. For Casey, mighty Casey, was advancing to the bat. There was ease in Casey's manner as he stepped up to the plate. There was style in Casey's bearing and a smile on Casey's face. And responding to the applause, he lightly doffed his hat. And no stranger in the crowd could doubt 'twas Casey at the bat. 10,000 eyes were on him as he rubbed his hands with dirt. 10,000 hands applauded as he wiped them on his shirt. And as the writhing pitcher ground the ball into his hip, defiance gleamed in Casey's eye. A sneer curled Casey's lip. And now the leather-covered sphere comes hurtling through the air. And Casey stood a-watching it in lofty grandeur there. Close by the sturdy batsman, the ball unheeded sped. "That ain't my style," said Casey. "Strike one," the umpire said. And from the benches, black with people, went up an awful roar like the pounding of the storm waves on a stern, distant shore. "Kill him! Kill the umpire!" shouted someone in the stand, and it's likely they'd have killed him had not Casey raised his hand. With a smile of Christian charity, great Casey's visage shone. He stilled the rising tumult, and he bade the game go on. And he signaled to the pitcher. Once more the spheroid flew, and Casey still ignored it. And the umpire said, "Strike two!" "Fraud!" cried the maddened thousands. And the echo answered, "Fraud!" But one stern look from Casey, and the multitude was awed. And they saw his face grow stern and cold, and they saw his muscles strain, and they knew that Casey would not let that ball go by again. The sneer is gone from Casey's lip. His teeth are clenched in hate. He pounds with cruel violence his bat upon the plate. And now the pitcher holds the ball, and now he lets it go. And now the air is shattered by the force of Casey's blow. Oh, somewhere in this favored land, the sun is shining bright. And somewhere bands are playing, and somewhere hearts are light. And somewhere men are laughing, and somewhere children shout. But there is no joy in Mudville. Mighty Casey has struck out.